Gary, thanks for joining us this morning. Retain list must be one of the toughest times as a manager, as seven players depart the club permanently, but they all leave with our best wishes for their future careers.
Yeah, I think it's one of the hardest parts of being the manager, I think, is picking a team every week and leaving good people out. And then obviously, at the end of some people's contract, you have to kind of let them go from the club. I think we've done it in a really human way. I think we've always been fair to the players that haven't been playing. We've always, you know, kept in kind of good communications with them, kept working with them, kept supporting them. And then when it comes to the end, it almost kind of had a natural ending for a lot of the players. And I spoke to every single one of them. They leave with our kind of best wishes. I think they leave with a good feeling about Exeter City. I think they've all had, you know, in their own different ways, really good moments here. And definitely all of them have said they've thanked the club really for kind of the warmth that they've felt since they've been at the club. And you know, a special place for Exeter City in their heart, I think, as they leave.
Just touching on those briefly, Gary Woods, someone who proved to be a great backup option for you and a fantastic part of the dressing room and the goalkeeper union.
Yeah, Woodsy was a great signing at the time. I think we needed cover. We needed someone to come in and really push Jammer. He did that. He got in the team. He did really well in periods when he first came into the team. And then obviously this year he faced, you know, real competition from Veal, who was outstanding, you know, as you've seen recently, won every single award and the end of season awards. But Woodsy was always there to support Veal. He was a brilliant experience for not just Veal, but for Sean, for Harry Lee as well. He's always a great character in the dressing room. He's always bubbly and always a great support for me and the staff as well, with his experience to give us that insight in the changing room. So, you know, can't thank Woodsy enough for what he's done since he's been at the club. We wish him well wherever he goes. He still wants to play. I think he still can play and be a really good number one for someone. So hopefully he keeps his career going somewhere this summer.
Carl Taylor, someone who was so unlucky with that injury that he suffered, 18 months ago or more, did really well to get back to a place where he could offer, you know, could play for you. But I guess at his age, it's important that he goes and plays first team football regularly.
Yeah, I think so. I think, look, this time last year, we weren't sure if Kyle would ever play again. That's been really honest. You know, he had a serious injury and he has worked extremely hard. He has trained pretty much every single day this year. He has been fully fit for large periods, barring a little ankle injury in pre-season. But he has shown a character and a resilience that you need to be a professional football player. And also, he has a massive technical ability. I think that's why we signed him. You know, way back, it was Matty Taylor that signed him. But he has a great technical ability that I think would be a huge asset for any football club. So hopefully, again, Kyle finds a home. He finds somewhere where he can go and play and show that ability week in, week out, because he's worked extremely hard to get to a level where he can do that. And again, he leaves with our thanks. You know, he scored a big goal for us this year in the Cup. He came on in difficult moments in games and performed really well. So again, he leaves with our thanks and hopefully his career can go on from strength to strength from here.
The pair of Harry Kite and Alex Archers, you know, we've spoken about at length already, but as Academy graduates, you know, we hope they go on to have really successful careers.
Yeah, look, I think I've said it many times. It's always a sad moment, but a proud moment at the same time when Academy players leave. Hopefully, they go into the wider football world and have fantastic careers. There's so many success stories from our academy. Obviously, Ollie Watkins being the flagship one of that in terms of what he's doing in the Premier League. But, you know, Archie Collins is in the playoff semi-final this week with Peterborough. Sparks has won promotion with Portsmouth this year. Josh Key has had an amazing season in the Championship and scored a big goal against Plymouth, which was great to see. But all these players, you know, that leave our academy are going on to have fantastic careers, and hopefully Harry and Alex are another two that can go and do that.
And James Scott is one that doesn't come as a surprise. He mentioned in January that he would be departing at the end of his contract, but I guess, you know, our best wishes with him and hope that he can resurrect his career back in Scotland.
Yeah, as I've said, you know, James is you know, a great talent, a great character. It just didn't work out for him here. And, you know, he's went up to Scotland and been involved in bits for St Mirren, who are having a great season. But he has a big summer ahead of him, big pre-season, and hopefully he gets fit and starts to show that on a more regular basis.
And the pair of Joe O'Connor and Harrison King will be departing as well. At their age, again, I guess it's important that they find a club where they can, you know, play week in, week out.
Yeah, for young players, I think it's even more difficult who haven't, you know, had that experience of first team. They're still trying to forge a way in their career, and it's really difficult to let those young players go because they were given everything, but, you know, it just wasn't to be at Exeter. And again, we will support them. We will give them everything they need so that they're fit in the summer. They're ready to go into a different club and restart their career somewhere else.
Those players in contract negotiations at the moment, how close are you to knowing, you know, either way, if they're going to stay or will be leaving?
The big question, Scott, it's a huge frustration of mine. I'm sure the supporters are eager to see, you know, these players getting re-signed. I think to get Jack Aitchison signed up for another year recently shows the club's intent. It shows that we want to build a core group of players who can be successful over a number of years at this football club. So we're working extremely hard on all the ones. I know the supporters will know who they are, and hopefully those players commit to Exeter very soon.
Do they have a deadline or anything that contracts have to be signed by, or have you set anything for them?
Look, we spoke to them. I think we've obviously worked with these players. It's different from a kind of signing from outside the football club, because you're kind of putting a deadline on that. You need it to happen. We're a little bit more flexible. We understand, you know, everyone's situation is different. Everyone has different needs within a contract. Everyone has family situations. So we're working with all of that to try and make it happen. But we want it to happen sooner rather than later, so that come the 20th of June, we have pretty much or as much as our squad as we can put together comes in on the 20th of June, ready to start the hard work and preparation for the following season.
So watch this space is what you're saying, I guess, for those ones.
Yeah. You'll be busy, hopefully, yeah. Soon.
We must thank all those, the six heading back to their parent clubs as well, who we had on loan. I mean, they've all made a fantastic impact on the season, and especially those who joined in January as well.
Yeah, I think loan players are really important at this level. I think we are a fantastic club for loan players in terms of what we can provide with the facilities at Cliff Hill, the environment at SGP, the support that the players get from staff, from the club, from the supporters. So I think we are a brilliant club for loan players to come in. I think every loan player that has came has gave us something. I think, you know, you look at what Veal done in terms of his career, the minutes he's played, getting player of the year from where he was last season, not playing at Burton. It shows what we can do for these younger players. And again, next year we'll look to the Premier League clubs, the Championship clubs, for their, you know, best young talent to come and support the squad that we are trying to put together. But for all the boys that came, I thank all of them. They committed to the football club. They bought into everything Exeter City is about. And having been on loan a few times myself, I understand how difficult that is. So, you know, thank you to all of them for what they did this year, because they were all excellent.
It's early days, I guess, but will we be looking to, if possible, get any of them back on loan again for next season?
Yes, we will, Scott. And hopefully, and look, it's their parent club that looks after those players. So that, again, is something that's out with our control. We have to be guided by the parent club. But I think what we have done in the last few years is develop great relationships with Fulham, with Brentford, with Aston Villa, with Chelsea. You know, and showing these, you know, Premier League clubs how we can support their younger players, how we can provide them the minutes, the experience that they need to progress their careers. And, you know, hopefully we can get more players in the future from these clubs.
Tom Dean signed a pro contract, someone we saw in pre-season last year. And I think he, you know, made a couple of appearances in the EFL trophy this season. But he's scored 22 goals from midfield for the under-18s. Someone, you know, could has a good future ahead of him. And what will his next steps be?
He's got a big summer ahead of him. We actually spoke to all the younger players before we left and, you know, reiterated how much the off-season will help them when they come back, how important it is that they work hard. They don't just go away and forget about football. They still have to keep their fitness up. And Tom is, you know, coming into an environment that will, you know, really shock him. I think last year we found a lot of the younger players struggled in pre-season because they weren't prepared for what was coming. So hopefully Tom, he is a naturally fit lad. He's, any time he comes up with the first team, his attitude and his enthusiasm has been brilliant. He will need that this summer. And hopefully we can, you know, support him to develop and get better and get in the first team like, you know, Sonny Cox has this season and like other younger players have. So big summer for him, and hopefully he can kick on after pre-season and get involved.
Jake Richards, someone who's featured, you know, a lot for you this season at only 16. Can you just explain a little bit about his current situation?
Yeah, Jake is still a scholar because he's obviously still so young. We can't actually sign him on a professional contract. We have offered him, I think it's 2 or 3 now, because he keeps doing so well that we keep putting different contract offers in front of him. And when he's 17, he can sign that contract and extend his stay at the club. He's obviously been a huge success story this year. There's not many 16-year-olds play anywhere. And football, never mind in League One. So for him to have started as many games as he has this year at such a young age shows the talent and the potential he has. And like I said, hopefully, you know, when that contract gets put in front of him, he signs it and he stays here.
And how pleasing is it for you to have such a strong core of a first team ready, you know, to start pre-season compared to last year?
Yeah, that was the big challenge for us all at the club, to not just build a team for one season or for you know, 1 or 2 windows. We want to try and build a team for the years to come. Hence the signing of Jack when he's got a year left, to try and give him another year so that, you know, he is set here. He knows what he has to do. He's only focused on working on his game and developing his game and getting better. So to have, I think at the moment it's looking like about 14, 15. Hopefully we can then make that even bigger throughout the summer with the players we're trying to re-sign, with loan players potentially coming back, and obviously new signings as well. But the more players we can get in the group that understand how we play, that when they come back they're not learning a different way of playing, they're not creating new relationships, those relationships and that understanding is already there, I think that's really important for how we progress every year as a football club.
And what will you be looking to add in the transfer window? You know, with that strong core, is it more experience or more different types of players or things that complement what we've got? I guess it's kind of an interesting window for you this time.
Yeah, as I think we're looking, the big thing we look for is good people. I think since I've been at the club, we've recruited really well, but the big thing we've recruited is good people. And I think last year was a great example of that. In that difficult period, everyone stood together, everyone kept working, everyone supported each other, and that's because we have, you know, really good characters at the football club. So first and foremost, we want good people, good characters who want to come, who want to develop, who want to go on a journey with the football club. And then on top of that, we obviously want good players. You know, you see, when you get good players in the building, then it makes such a big difference. And when we had, you know, good players to pick from in the second half of the season, and it was a challenge not just to pick the team but to pick the finishers, leaving good players out, creating competition, I think that's really important. So hopefully come the end of this window, we can get that again so that we can really attack League One again this season.
With the success story of, you know, Reece Cole, Vinnie Harper and Millie Alley coming from the National League to and below to be so successful this season, I guess, you know, that shows how many quality players there are in divisions below us as well.
Yeah, I think it does. And I think it shows the strength of the staff we have at the football club, that, no matter who we bring in, whether it's, you know, a young player from non-league or whether it's older players like Ryan Woods, like Tom Carroll, we can help these players either revive their career like Tom and Woodsy have this season, or we can develop young players like Vinny, like Millie. And really, you know, all these players are coming into the club to develop, to help us improve, but to take us forward. And that's the big thing that I think the staff deserve a lot of credit, that we have, you know, every player we've brought in, I think we've worked with these players and we've made them better. And they are kind of coming on this journey with us. And hopefully that continues again next season.
And football fans can get a little bit overexcited by the window opening. You know, we've already seen a couple of sign someones on social media. I mean, what can you say to them about expectations for the window?
The expectation is always the same for me. It's to be better as a squad, to create more competition within the squad come the end of the window. I think at Exeter City, we have to do that a different way. We have to be patient in how we go about that. We can't, you know, just throw money at people early in the window to get them to the football club. We have to get the right people who want to be here. And that takes time. That takes, you know, meetings with players. I'm meeting a player this afternoon. So I have to get to know these people that we want to bring to the club. And through that process, you know, the supporters have to be patient. And I think they've always seen at the end of the window, even though we'd all like it to be quicker and like these players to come in earlier, at the end of every window, I think the supporters have been fairly happy with what we've done and you know, what the squad has looked like. So I'll ask them again to show that patience, which I think we're lucky at this football club. We have supporters that understand the football club and how it works. But show that patience again, and hopefully at the end of the window, they can see a squad that is ready to give them everything again next season.
Just finally, just to touch on pre-season plans as well. I know nothing's been announced just yet, but if you just want to kind of talk through, you know, the plan for pre-season in terms of matches in the local area. And
yeah, pre-season's pretty similar to last season. We're coming back the 20th of June. The players are actually working before that with Les, with Kev, and Michael and Sam and Tom. The boys will be coming in 3 days a week, and then I think it actually starts in the next week or two. So the players are working right through the summer so that come the 20th of June, they're ready to go again. We will be fairly local in terms of our early games. We're possibly going to trip away again, you know, in Cornwall, and then the games will kind of will broaden out in terms of where we go a bit further afield, not too far, but. And the quality kind of goes up as we go through pre-season as well. Still trying to arrange a home game, which has proven really difficult for the first week or the week before the first game of the season. And hopefully we can get that finalised very soon as well. But everything apart from that game is in place. Everyone is clear on what we need to do in terms of the staff. And I think it's important the staff also get a rest and everyone comes back really fresh and really hungry and ready to go again on the 20th of June.
And that local pre-season, you know, campaign gives fans the opportunities to actually go and see the team and support them. But also it's saying thanks to those teams that, you know, take our players on loan and earn them a bit of money as well.
Yeah, I've done it at every club I've been at and last season I did it. And I think it's really important. The crowds we've got at Tiverton, at Taunton is great for these teams. So, you know, I will not go to all the same places, but we'll get to local clubs again and play these teams and give them that support that we need in terms of the crowd and the finances that brings. So I think, you know, for everything they do for us, I think that's the least we can do for them.
Brilliant. Thank you very much.
Cheers, Scott.